Bonjour monsieur et madame, it is me le chef Reddit, today I have a special ala Reddit for you. Bon appétit and remember to subscribe.
What common product has a feature you're not sure everyone is aware of? Microsoft Word has a reference section that will auto-format bibliographies and in-text citations with different styles. All you have to do is add the sources and it does everything else. I only found out a couple of weeks ago that with most Android phones you can double tap the button that shows your open apps to switch between the last two you used. Edit really didn't think this would blow up, but I'm glad I'm not the only one who didn't know about it. Thanks for the gold. Have you ever accidentally kept caps lock on while writing in Microsoft Word? You can highlight the text, then press Shift and F3 to undo it. If you press those same buttons again, each sentence will have its first letter capitalized. Most toasters have little removable trays at the bottom that catch the crumbs that fall off the bread. It turns out that you can empty those periodically to keep from accidentally burning down your house. That notch in the blade of your kitchen shears is for cutting things like flower stems and chicken bones that would otherwise just slide out when you try to cut them. Phones can record horizontal video, just like watching video on a television screen. Leaving a voicemail. Nearly all voicemail machines allow you to press asterisk and re-record if you fucked up your message. Most people don't know this and feel like idiots when they fuck up the message. You can turn off the sound from those annoying videos at the gas pump by hitting the buttons on the right from the top down in sequence. If you plug in a regular controller to the NES while playing Duck Hunt, it controls the ducks. Edit, the light gun only works with a CRT, C. Cell phones can be held up to your ear so you talk in a normal voice instead of holding the phone like it's toast you're about to eat and letting everyone in a 12-foot radius hear your entire conversation. If you own a dog of at least 35-ish pounds, then you also own a footrest. Source, my dog doubles as a footrest. Also a towel. And a package delivery alert system. She's basically a Swiss Army knife I have to feed. Use Ctrl plus Shift plus T to open up the last tab you accidentally closed. Edit rip my inbox you bunch of morons. Dry erase markers work very well at getting permanent marker off of things. However, it only really works on hard, non-porous surfaces. Edit, I've been getting tons of great replies of other substances that work well at removing permanent marker. To save you time, here is a list, based on the comments. Permanent marker, got to wipe it away fast. Rubbing alcohol. Other types of hard alcohol, especially vodka because it is distilled, hand sanitizer because it's alcohol-based, hairspray. Plain pencil erasers, especially Mars brand, honorable mention, dry erase marker also works well to get dry erase marker stains off of whiteboards. That's what I use on old red dry erase stains. Thanks everyone for the awesome replies laughing face. If you make a contact in your phone as fuck fucking fucker, you will never get the ducking fucking autocorrect. You are welcome my foul-mouthed friends. OMG I got gold, I'm so excited thank you fuckers. Many phone cameras can see infrared. Point a remote at your phone, push a button, and watch your screen. You should be able to see the light that comes from the remote. Every time I post this, people get impressed. Ctrl plus V pastes. Ctrl plus Shift plus V pastes without formatting. Edit, I am glad to have blessed my people with shortcut knowledge. Next, someone's going to have to bring out the gospel of Ctrl plus Shift plus T. Just recently realized that shaking a window of an application minimizes all the others that you have open, and it's not just my Windows being stupid as usual. And that it's done so you can hide your browser at work when your boss comes in. Edit, since everyone's asking how to do it. The application has to be in window mode, may work a bit wonky if it's maximized. Grab the top bar of the window and shake it left to right or up and down a couple of times. It will minimize all the other windows you have open, and if you shake it again, it will restore them. Should work for Windows Vista 7, 8, 10. Edit 2. I quite enjoy the thought that I just made you all shake your mouses, mice, laptops, and phones uncontrollably. Edit 3, thank you for the gold, nice words and love confessions. Reddit has night mode. I suggest everyone to use it if they are like me and browse primarily on a mobile device. Modern elevators in buildings. At least in NYC. I'm sure elsewhere as well. *1 ding, single note, hi, the elevator is going up. *2 dings, two notes, hi, low, the elevator is going down. I believe it's mainly for the visually impaired. Baking soda is phenomenal at cleaning sinks and tubs. Just sprinkle it on dry and use a dry cloth and it erases the stains. Vinegar, add a cup at the rinse cycle along with detergent. It makes an excellent fabric softener for cotton-based fabrics. If you add it in the beginning, it will lessen the efficacy of the detergent. It also does not leave a smell once the fabrics have dried. Have residue from tape or stickers that won't easily come off, just smear some peanut butter on it and leave it alone for an hour. Wipe it off with a paper towel, the peanut butter breaks down the adhesive. Clogged sink or tub, get a shop vac and suck the clog out. If it doesn't come out that way, put it in reverse and blow it out. Most ovens range hoods can be opened and propped up like a car hood, making it easier to clean underneath. A good household tip, especially for the ladies, is that hydrogen peroxide lifts blood stains perfectly. Don't try to wash blood off with hot water, that will make it bond to the fabric. Baby onesies have that weird shoulder construction so that when baby has a blowout and there's shit everywhere, you can pull the onesie down off the baby to avoid smearing shit on baby's face, hair, upper half. Edit, and also to fit over their ginormous baby heads, of course. Not so much a product but a service, your local library almost certainly offers free ebooks and audiobooks via OverDrive. All you need is a library card number and a PIN. Many libraries also offer online learning courses like Lynda. They're a delight. You know those rolls of tin foil plastic wrap that come in the long rectangle boxes? They have tabs on either end that you're supposed to push in, and it keeps the roll in place so you don't have to hold it down when you unravel it. Gasoline will cut through most grease and glue. It will almost instantly dissolve duct tape adhesive. Liquid dish detergent is really good for taking oily, greasy stains out of clothes, the kind that are still there even after a cycle through the washer. For even better results, put the dish detergent on the stain, dampen the area, and then sprinkle salt on it. I dunno why it works, but it does. I've had stains that have already gone through the dryer that came out next washing with this method. Edit, added the liquid. I don't mean people to think you're using the powdered stuff. I meant liquid dish soap like Dawn or Ajax or whatever. They're a bit at the end of a stapler you can reverse so the staples bend out instead of in, for a less permanent stapling that is easier to remove by hand. In Excel, you can press F4 to cycle between the different types of absolute cell references. *Ctrl+F* allows you to search for a word. So say you want mention something like turn signals in a particular post, Ctrl+F would allow you to see how many other people have mentioned the same thing. Most electronic push-to-start keys for a car actually have a physical key hidden inside it in case the battery to the key fob dies. The valves on coffee bags are not for you to smell, although you certainly can. Rather, they are to release gases like CO2 whilst not letting back in oxygen, which stales coffee. Coffee emits a lot of gas after being roasted, so if that valve wasn't on there, bags would puff up and possibly explode. Might be obvious, but most times someone's over my shoulder on my computer, they seem surprised. In most browsers, if you want to Google some text from a web page, you can highlight it and drag it up to the tabs area. No need to copy and paste or right-click. A lot of automobiles come equipped from the factory with turn signals. The gas pump icon next to the fuel meter in your car often has a small arrow next to it indicating what side the fuel lid is on, good for evading awkward situations at gas stations. The little knife on a wine opener is to cleanly cut off the wrapper around most wine bottles. I have seen people who have been waiting per bartending for years and use the actual corkscrew to try and rip it off. Add on, to all the people who keep saying, you can just pull it off, you are missing the point. The topic is functions of devices people don't know, not, is that function useful? Also IDK where these easily twist off like champagne foil regular wine bottles are cause the only bottles I have you could easily just twist off the top metal are screw caps. Windows 10 Pro or education versions has Hyper-V available as a feature that can be enabled for free. It's for running virtual machines like VirtualBox or VMware Workstation does. Instant oatmeal packets are lined so you can use them to measure and pour your water. With many car key remotes, you can make all the windows go down at once by pushing the unlock button 3 times. First time unlocks the driver's door, second time unlocks the passenger doors, third time lowers all windows at the same time, a handy feature in warm weather. The Hitachi Magic Wand is useful for more muscles than you might think. Your iPhone gathers a lot more location data than you may have originally thought. It's a setting called Frequent Locations. As you go about your daily routine, your iPhone makes note of where you are and how long you're there. When it starts detecting patterns, it marks the spot as one such frequent location. It, rather accurately, assumes workplace location based on where you are during the day and your house address based on where you are at night, and it tracks various repeated locations regardless of time, friends' houses, favorite restaurants and the like. If Facebook keeps suggesting the same people you may know even after you click ignore, it may be because that person has been searching for you. Microsoft Excel allows you to password lock whole sheets or just sections of sheets. This means you can save a template and don't have to worry about it getting messed up. Or you can lock the sheet so when you send it off, nobody can screw it up and blame it on you. Jane, I hate you so much, I hope the accounting wing burns to the ground. Windows has a built-in Clip It tool for you to select certain areas on the screen to copy instead of doing an entire screen capture and then cropping.
Thank you for watching. What was your favorite answer? Do you have a better one? Comment it down below. Au revoir.